I don't know if American television is now just dog water or if I'm an adult and became the Squidward I'd always feared I'd become. But we're talking today about Netflix, all right? There's three major news stories that have happened in the past few weeks in America. One, Elon Musk bought Twitter. Wow, we'll see where that goes. Two, Amber Heard and Johnny Depp are having the funniest trial, which we'll probably talk about in another Mogul Mail. And three, Netflix is in the shitter. All right, I don't even mind swearing in the first 30 seconds of this video. I'll lose a few hundred dollars. It's not as bad as Netflix. I'm always doing better than them. They've lost 44% of the revenue in the past month, 68% of the revenue in the past 6 months. That's insane. And the reason is because they released their quarterly earnings and they've lost subscribers for the first time in years. And their expectation is that they'll lose even more next quarter. If you don't know, they have the most outdated subscription model, all right? This is it. They have a basic plan. It's $10 a month. $10 a month, okay? That's like the price of YouTube Premium, which removes all ads from all YouTube videos, which I use and is godlike. And it gets you 480p streaming on one device. 480p. Why are you even offering 480p anymore? Unless this is a Super Smash Brothers Melee tournament that is going to give $40 to first place, there's no reason to have a 480p anywhere. If you want to go HD, normal, it's $15. And if you want to go, finally, 4K Ultra, which not even all shows have, it's $20 a month, which is insane, especially because it's the same price across the board for all markets. So you're paying $20 even if you're median income in your countries is way, way under that. That's something that even Twitch figured out. Even Twitch was like, yo, we should change the price of like subscriptions if the median income is a fifth of the American median income. But ignoring all that, all right, they have an even bigger problem, which is their dog shit shows. Now, I've been watching this show lately and it's my guilty pleasure. Okay. I'm embarrassed to admit that I've watched multiple episodes of this show. And I secretly kind of enjoy it, even though I know, objectively, it's so bad. It's called Is It Cake? And the premise is exactly how it sounds, where contestants go make a cake, and they try to fool judges into believing that their cake is a real household object. The trend from like 2 years ago, they made a Netflix show this year. And they have SNL host Mikey Day, who's running the show. And the show, if you could imagine, is as over-the-top, cringe, and it's kind of like Marvel ha-ha humor at every moment, where it's like, look at camera and be like, is that fondant? And then, you know, wipe, you know, powder sugar off your shoulder. I'll show you just one clip, and you can form your opinion just off this, knowing that there is more to the show, but let's take a look.
Oh, that's fondant. Okay.
Learning how to use cake? Funny. Ha-ha. These are all the artists making their cake.
All right, 10 minutes left, bakers. And I know a lot more about cake now.
The whole shtick is that the SNL host, Mikey Day, knows nothing about cakes. And it's very apparent. At one point, the contestants who are not participating mock him for how little he knows.
I hope you guys used your sugar shapers. Or a
every time.
Dresden tool.
Yeah.
I don't know what that is. Woo!
Or break the fourth wall again.
Eggs.
Yeah.
Oh, looks cool.
But it's every moment of the show. But look, I still watch it because even though it is so damn bad in every other comedy line makes you cringe, the cakes are kind of cool to look at the end. All right, they're kind of cool. I will share one thing that pissed me off. If you've been watching this show, you might know this. But one of the contestants, you're supposed to write make a cake and disguise it in with other objects, cheated. He outright cheated because he was supposed to make fake tacos, fake cake tacos.
Turned out pretty well, but I don't want the decoys to look perfect.
He basically put cake shit into real tacos to make his fake taco look better. And then he ended up winning that episode. And they didn't talk about it at all, because none of the contestants at least claimed they did
that. So, I'm gonna put some of my deep red tomatoes on one of them in hopes that they look fake.
It worked. It worked exactly according to plan. He cheated. Anyway, that's just me being mad about a show that's really bad. But that, I mean, that's the problem. It feels like there hasn't been a show on Netflix in years that I would go up to someone and be like, yo, you got to check that out. With the sole exception of the recent show that's a hit called Old Enough, where it's just like a Japanese kid who's like 2 years old and his parents sent him on a mission to go to a grocery store to buy like curry sauce. And the kid has to go by himself at like 2 years old and do it. And secret cameramen follow him around. And it's definitely like a little scripted, but like it should be. You know, it's a 2-year-old kid. You shouldn't have him walking through streets of Japan by themselves. Even if it is Japan and not like Los Angeles, California, where you probably lose custody of your children if you participate in the show. The problem with this being the new hit show of Netflix, it's like a 20-year-old show. Like, this has been a hit in Japan for years. They have a different name in Japan. It's called, like, First Errand or something. And the kids all have to do one errand. And again, yeah, it's just finally been translated and marketed to an English-speaking audience. But it's been around. And that's like, the biggest show that they've had. And I don't know, like, most of the days nowadays, I just watch YouTube and Twitch. That's pretty much all I've been watching. Because it feels like every other show is not worth it. It's just a time burner. It has forced me to become a weeb. I don't want to be a weeb. All right, I'm going to make that very clear. I am not a fan of being a weeb. But this is the show that's available on cable television and Netflix. All right, this is a real scene from cable television's show, The Masked Singer. All right, I gave up cable a while ago. I bought it briefly because I wanted to watch NFL. And for some fucking reason, you have to spend like $40 a month to watch the NFL if you're in America. But this is the hit show right now. If you don't know, The Masked Singer is another singing show where the singer is masked and they finally reveal themselves to the audience and the judges. And in Mayor of New York and lawyer of Donald Trump, Rudy Giuliani, revealed himself on the show. And then this happened.
That's
Ken Jeong walking off the show.
Before I am through, I want to be yours, pretty baby. Yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you.
And that, by the way, if you're curious,
yeah, honey, that I'm bad to the bone,
is Jenny McCarthy. All right? Who was an anti-vaxxer before it was cool in the South. And she's losing it at Rudy Giuliani's off-pitch attempt at singing Bad to the Bone.
Bad to the bone. Bad.
This is the guy who was part of fucking Trump's scheme in the whole January 6th thing. It's crazy. I mean, this is must-watch TV nowadays for cable television. Look, it feels like all shows these days are only the shows that are so bad you have to watch them. Not just genuinely good shows that will last for a decade because it was well written and deserves to be watched. You know, even the newer shit made by people who should know how to make shows, like the person who made the sequel to Twin Peaks. Twin Peaks just came out. That's the show that's made by David Lynch. It was a huge hit, all right, for ABC in the 90s, and they made a new version of it. I haven't watched it. But I trust my good friend Slime, who loves reading. He's like, that show's dog shit too. And I miss the era where there was a show that everyone watched. It was like uniting in a way. The last time I really felt it was with Game of Thrones, all right? And everybody would watch every week and it'd be like the talk of the town on Twitter or wherever with your friends. You would have to watch it so you could be a part of social discourse. That's how good the shows were. And that's what it used to be like all the time when I was younger. And nowadays, the binging model, right? It kind of happens with like Queen's Gambit or something like that comes around. But you don't really know where everyone's at in the show. Like Squid Game, and you're like, oh, how far are you? Okay, I don't want to spoil. Rather than the weekly model. Maybe I'm dumb. Maybe this is a terrible take, but I think Charlie had a similar one. I want to go back. I want to go back to the weekly model. I want to go back to being able to have one thing that we all communally enjoy together and can discuss together, rather than, oh, I didn't realize you were on episode 3. I'm on episode 10. The ending, just so you know, gets crazy. You have to have these weird conversations rather than everyone being on the same page. But that's it. That's all I got. Netflix hitting the shitter. Feels like all American TV sucks nowadays. Anyway, back to Twitch and YouTube grind. I guess you are watching this right now, so you also might agree with me on some level. Like, if Game of Thrones was still on TV, you'd probably watch that over me talking unedited for 10 minutes in 40 seconds straight. Just a guess. Anyway, thank you for watching. I appreciate it. We'll do a mogul mail on Johnny Depp and Amber Heard, because that's all of my TikTok For You page. And I have been secretly soaking up every single second of the drama. Subscribe, by the way, if you haven't, because they're like 60% of the people who watch this don't subscribe. And goodbye forever now. See you later.